So we have x is equal to 6 and x is equal to minus 6 is the answer. Okay, so this is the way how to solve the problem. So after that problem, it is given out, given in the form of quadratic. First you solve completely, get the expression first. After that you can transpose and do, whether it may be using by identity or by sum product rule, you can decide and do the problem, and finally you can get the answer like this. Okay, and next I am going to solve your 20th problem. 20th problem, it's nothing but 6x into 3x minus 7. So next, 20th question, 6x into 3x minus 7 is equal to 7 into 7 minus 3x. Okay, so now this is also, it is not in the form of quadratic. So first what we want to do, we want to remove the bracket. We want to solve completely this one first. So want to remove the bracket, we want to multiply this number inside. So multiply 6 inside first with the first term as well as the second term, because the what is the number, it is outside this number, it's common for both terms. Okay, so you have to multiply it inside. Similarly for RHS side also you have to multiply. So what is the answer? 6 into 3. First you multiply the coefficient number. 6 3s are 18. X into x, x is square. Minus, because here minus and this is positive number. So plus into minus, minus. 6 7s are 42 and x also we have. So 42x. And similarly multiply this side. 7 7s are 49 minus 7 3s are 21 into x. Okay, wow. So next we want to transpose everything one side, because we want to make it as a quadratic equation. Quadratic equation in the sense we should have only three term, x square term, x term and the constant term, right? So these two numbers you transpose LHS side. Next you get 18x square minus 42x and plus 49 will change into minus 49 and minus 21x will change into plus 21x is equal to 0. Okay, so after that, no need to solve these two. For convenient, I'm just going to write x term near to here. Okay, see, 18x square minus 42x plus 21x minus 49 equal to 0. Because already it is in the form of splitting the middle term. Because the splitting the middle term, we have the middle term is x value. So no need to use that product and some method to find out here. After you have reached this step, you can grouping the first two numbers and the next two numbers. Just look at that, any common factor is available here. So how to write your 6, 18, it is 6 into 3. And x square can return as x into x. 42, how can we write? It is 6 into 7 into x. Now you see here both the terms. What are all the numbers are common? Here we have 6 and here also we have 6. And here we have x and here also we have x. So I have 6x is common for both the numbers. So I can take out 6x commonly outside. What is remaining here? 3 and x. So it is 3x and here it is remaining only 7 minus 7. So like this, the same way you have to apply here also. For 21x, how can you write 7 into 3 into x, right? And 49 we can write 7 into 7. Now you see what is common, 7 is common. Take 7 commonly outside. So if you are taking commonly 7 outside, what is remaining? 3x minus here 1, 7 is remaining. Okay, so now just look at here, what is next, what is common? We have 3x minus 7 and 3x minus 7. In the first term also we have 3x minus 7, second term also we have 3x minus 7. So take 3x minus 7 commonly outside. Okay, so what is remaining here? 6x and here it is 7 is remaining. So write 6x plus 7 is equal to 0. So after you have reached the linear factor, what is the procedure? We want to equating to 0 separately. So 3x minus 7 equal to 0 or 6x plus 7 equal to 0. Okay. So we have reached 3x minus 7 equal to 0 or 6x plus 7 equal to 0. So this linear factor we want to solve and get the value of x. So first you transpose this minus 7 this side. So minus 7 will change into plus 7. And next you transpose 3 next side. And x it is in the form of multiplication. If you are transposing next side, it will become division. So 7 divided by 3. This is one root. Another root here you have to transpose 7 next side. So 6x is equal to minus 7. Then you transpose 6 next side. It is along with x, it is in the form of product. So the product number will change into division. So this is your another root. Okay. So we have two numbers now.